morning to you, boys and girls. It's Saturday, the 1st of April, 2017. Welcome along to this morning's United Kingdom Talk. Have you been tripped up by any of those dreadful April Fool's jokes yet? I wonder, boys and girls, there might be a few of those coming up this morning. It's been a bit of a struggle this morning trying to get through the... because we always have a fake news item. There might be one or two today. I'm scanning through the papers, not actually showing. Good morning to Duffy. Morning, Duffy. Not actually sure which is fake and which is new this morning. So we'll have a little look later on and see if we can suss some of those out, boys and girls. All right. Just a second. There we go. So are you like me? You know that music? That music I play at the beginning. Oh, you may have noticed I had to restart this morning. We started the show and I've got the thing on and I thought, I can't hear the music. Very, very important to have that music. Very, very dramatic, dear. We've not got some pansy music. Do, 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 do. We haven't got anything like that, dear. We haven't got anything like that. Da, 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 da. Very, very dramatic, as written by the great David Arnold Music. Thank you very much, David Arnold, for giving me permission to use that piece of music. Very grateful, very grateful. Let's say hello to the early people this morning. There's only a few of you there this morning, isn't there? Adam's there, Terry's there. They're the only message I can see at the moment, actually. Is that right? Yeah, only four. That's very, very quiet. Where is everyone today? Ah, I know. It's an April Fool joke. You're pretending not to be there, aren't you? That is your April Fool joke to me. Yes, I thought so. And can we please have... So do make sure you turn that music right up when it comes on. And the little triangle, the little diamond is going like that. It's all very dramatic, very dramatic. Good news this morning, and I want you to give a round of applause. Oh my God, Duffy had snow last night. Where are you, Duffy? She had snow last night. I hate snow. I hate snow and cold weather. Oh, let's go skiing. Don't think so, darling. Oh, what about Ottawa? She's in Ottawa in the USA. Oh, my God, we don't like the snow, dear. No snow, thank you very much. No. Anyway, where was I going now? Oh, yes. Can we please have a massive round of applause this morning for Katie the Cat, who obviously, when I got up this morning, at some point this morning or last night, has found the cat litter tray. Yeah! That's the first time she's gone to number twos in the cat litter tray and not on her puppy pads, which are working quite well, the puppy pads, although they don't soak it all up. A little bit disappointed. A little bit disappointed with the puppy pads. She's gone for a wee on there, and yeah, it soaks some of it up, but some of it still goes through to my very, very expensive slate tiles on the floor. Yes. Poor Katie. For a round of applause. Well done for doing number twos. That's the first time she's done that in weeks in the cat litter tray. So pleased about that. Oh, hang on a minute. I've got the wrong... That's not the bit of paper I wrote out earlier. Where's that gone now? Oh, dear. I mean, why do I bother doing all this? I mean, yesterday's one. Just a second. Is this it here? Oh, a minute. What's this? Sorry. Talk amongst yourselves for a moment. That's not it. What's this? No, that's not it. Ah, here it is. How did that happen? I'm sure that was on the top of the pile when I did it. It's at the bottom of the pile now, but never mind, never mind. So let's have a look. Ah, so some of you are asking about my mate's arm because he had a plasma injection into his arm on Thursday, boys and girls, because he got tennis elbow. What they do, I think they took blood out of him. They put it in this machine that goes whirring around, and then it separates some the white stuff from the red stuff. And then that goes in an injection, and it gets injected back into his elbow to hopefully alleviate the pain. But apparently it gets worse before it gets better. So he was in a bit of pain yesterday, but I did go over to visit him. And he's not too bad. He will come into the studio at some point and talk about his recent trip to New York City. New York, New York. Da, 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 da. We're on Facebook One this morning in full colour and also on Periscope. Now, you've heard me talking about Periscope recently, boys and girls, that I thought The American periscopes are far, far superior to ours. Now, if you don't know what Periscope is, it's like Facebook Live with messages, but that's it. It's not in any other way like Facebook Live. In fact, Periscope was before Facebook. Okay, Periscope came before Facebook, and you could fire up your phone, push a couple of buttons, and then you'd be on, sort of like I'm on now. You'd be on your little mobile phone, and people could click onto you. I mean, can you say tune in? Does that make sense? People could tune into you while you're doing your broadcast. You see, now. You've heard me talking about the Periscopers in London, especially at night, just awful. It's just off. All right, man, how you doing? Lighting up spliffs and just basically chatting each other up. That's all it is. It just seems to be a pickup joint for boys and girls as well. You know, the girls are there. Oh, and someone has sent them a message. You're really hot. Oh, thanks a lot. Oh, thanks a lot. Or there might be a boy on there, you know, saying that, and the girls wonder, oh, you're really hot, where are you, and all this. I suppose half an hour later they're meeting up and getting on with it, dear. I mean, that's all it is in the London. Really disappointing how that's gone in London. However, last night I clicked on and watched a few of the American ones. Very good. All sorts of things going on there. But last night I found a bloke on one of the London periscopes, and he was really good. He was playing the piano. Not only was he playing the piano, he was doing requests. He was literally sitting there. He's got his camera up here, so you can kind of see his face and his hands running up and down the keys. How old was he? Probably about 27, 30, something around that age. And he was playing the piano. And he was really very good. He was pleasant. People were asking him to play tunes. I think he did that one by Celine Dion. You know, the one she jumped off the ship. Here far, wherever you are, la da 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 da, my heart will go on and on.
Man overboard!
That was the foghorn on the ship, incidentally. But he didn't actually do the foghorn. That was just me doing the foghorn. He didn't do the foghorn. But he was there, and I watched him for about 10 minutes while I was lying in bed, actually. I was lying in bed. I was kind of nodding off to his music. It was lovely. How wonderful to see someone using Periscope to show us a bit of their talent rather than come round and let's have a bit. You know, it's true. He was fantastic. So if you want to look him up, now I'm not sure what his Periscope name would be, but it's going to be one of these two. It's either Frederico de Melo. That's a great name, isn't it? What's your name? Frederico de Melo. I love that name. It's either Frederico, F-R-E-D-E-R-I-C-O, space, de, D-E, space, M-E-L-O, M-E-L-O, okay? Or it's Fred Melodies, all one word. I would go for the Fred Melodies. Try typing into your Periscope Fred Melodies or Frederico de Melo. You'll be able to see the recording of his live show last night. And I thought that was really entertaining. Very, very impressed. It's probably one of the only Periscope shows that I've actually shared with everyone else on my Periscope. So keep an eye out for him. So now and again, you know, you might see a good Periscope or indeed a good Facebook Live. You know, there's some bad ones of these as well. I mean, it does make me laugh. It does make me laugh, you know, people at events, you know, whether it's a big show in London or a drag queen in a pub. And they go on the Facebook Live, and honestly, they're like this with the camera. And I'm like, who wants to watch that? No one wants to watch that. If this was shaking around like this, you wouldn't want to watch it, would you? Oh, can't watch that anymore. Reminds me of that film. Do you remember that film a few years ago now? Now, what was it called? But it was done like on a home video camera, and it was just shaking all the time. Maybe I had to leave in the end. It was awful. Gosh, what was it? It was some sort of science fiction-y type thing. They were in New York, I believe. And you never saw the monster until the end. And even then, I don't think you saw it properly. Does anyone remember what that was called? Cloverfield. Anyone see Cloverfield? Dreadful. Absolutely dreadful. Shake, this camera was shaking all the time. And of course, you know, when you go and first watch the film, I'm looking at this film sitting in the cinema like this. I'm like, oh, it's shaking. Oh, it'll get properly into the film in a minute and that will all stop. No, the whole blooming film was like that. Ghastly. And I think it won awards. How can something like that win an award? It's like Gravity. Did you watch Gravity? God, how boring was that? So boring, Gravity. And it won all these awards. How? Someone's knocking someone else out for that, I reckon. Dreadful film. And it was so dark. I took my nephew. This is 2014 or 15. We was in Florida. Me and Jimmy was in Florida, my nephew. And he fell asleep. We went into the cinema. I think there were three of us in there. There was me and him and another bloke right at the back. That was it in the whole cinema. This is in Universal Studios in Florida. The film started. And then after a while, I thought, oh, God, this is boring. Anyway, I'll carry on. And I looked over to my nephew. He's asleep. Not only was he asleep, his head had kind of dropped down to the top of his jacket like that. Jeez, how do these blooming films win awards, dear? There's been nothing good out since The Sound of Music. I'm telling you that now. It's all been rubbish since then. Let's say good morning to a few of our little friends joining us this morning. That's better. I've got your messages now. I don't think I was getting those up a second ago. Good morning to Ray Reynolds, who says, it's April already. Spring has sprung and a young man's fancy turns. Hi there, pop pickers. Yes, it's me again. Mr. Ray Reynolds is with us this morning. Morning, Ray. Lee Cobb is there. Good morning, Chris and everyone. Good morning, Lee. Hope you're well, sir. Adam. Oh, Lee. Do you know of any other Turkish hairdressers in this area? You know, that do hair burning and shaving and hot towels. Do you know of any others? Because I think Max is the only place that does that. Do you know of any others off by hand? I hope you don't mind me asking, because I know you're sort of around this area, aren't you? Good morning to Adam Tubero. Good morning, Adam. The plumber is with us. And I would like to thank Adam for his Slimming World book that he bought me in yesterday, which I haven't looked at yet. It's in my bag, which is still in the car, actually. So thank you very, very much for that, Adam. That is much appreciated. Sometimes people give me things like yourself, Adam, right at the beginning of the night, and I'm setting up, oh, and they give you something, and you put it to the side. Thanks very much. And then you get on with what you're doing. And sometimes I feel that, you know, later on, you don't really realise you've done that until much later on when you've finished the night, put everything, you're driving home, and you think, oh, maybe I came across as a little bit ungrateful there. Please do not think I've been ungrateful. Your mind is on the job while you're doing it, you know, setting stuff up and chatting away and pushing buttons for people. So thank you very much for that, Adam. Much, much appreciated. Thank you, Adam. Good morning to Terry H. is with us this morning. Good morning, Terry. Anne says, good morning, Chris. Want to see a picture of Barry Manilow naked? Ah, now, unfortunately, Anne, You've jumped the boat there because I have my Facebook statuses updates. What I do before we go on the show now is I have a look at people's Facebook status update. And is there anything that catches the eye? Aye, aye, Captain. By the way, this is not an advert for Bird's Eye Fish Fingers. I think I make a Captain Bird. Am I old enough to be Captain Bird's Eye? Perhaps not. You've got to be old, grey beard and fat, haven't you? I'll have a word with my best mate. I think he'll be able to carry that one out. Yes, I look for your Facebook status updates to see if there's anything that catches my eye. And I've got three for you. Only three this morning, boys and girls. There's a lot of April Fool's jokes in there, but only three this morning. And Anne Taplin have you actually bothered to type me a personal message there, Anne? Or have you cut and pasted? Is it just a cut and paste? I will not be cut and pasted. I will not. That's outrageous, being cut and pasted like that. Anyway, Anne says, wow, wow, holy cow, just found a couple of pictures of Manilow naked. Obviously cannot post them here, but if you want a sneaky peek, private message me and I will send them to you. Oh, Anne, you haven't, have you? Of course you haven't. That's an April Fool's joke. Ha ha, not going to get me. Not going to get me. I bet none of you can. Go on. Try and sort me out with some April Fool that I'm going to fall down on. Number two from James Buckley this morning. Good morning, James, who says, today is April Fool's Day. Believe nothing and trust no one, just like any other day on Facebook. That is absolutely true. trust no one. I'm not very good at trusting people, I must admit. Do you trust people? You can trust me. Trust me. You could give me £10 million and I would look after it for you and never spend a penny of it. That is true, that is. I'm a very, very, very trustworthy person. Unless I think you're taking the mick out of me. And then I do something. And then I'll probably do something to get my own back. Yeah, absolutely. Yes. I'm very, very trustworthy, very loyal person until I think you're taking the mick out of me. And then I'll do something to get my own back. Just remember that. All right. And only one more this morning. This is from Mandy Mungrew. Good morning, Mandy. Hope you're well this morning. Oh, it's karaoke tomorrow, by the way. If you're in Sydenham, it's our once a month outing to Sydenham at the Golden Lawn tomorrow. All right, so that's the 2nd of April. Karaoke Sunday, the 2nd of April, 9 p.m. to 12 midnight at the Golden Lawn in Sydenham if you're coming down there tomorrow. That's a nice little night. Anyway, Mandy writes, for sale, £60 or near offer. Lovely, comfy bra. Used for many years. Feels like a second skin and must be for any lady or man. You know, depend. I mean, Simon Cowell could wear one, couldn't he? Simon Cowell could absolutely wear a bra. I think I'm getting close to that now as well, dear. Darling. Yeah. All this no bread, no cakes, no crisps. I haven't lost any weight at all. What the hell's gone wrong with that? It worked last time. Anyway, feels like a second skin for almost any lady or man. I think it's very sexist, that is, Mandy. Men can wear bras as well. We can wear what we like, dear. You don't know what I've got on under here. I've got a very, very short leather miniskirt, thigh-length boots, crutchless knickers, and those stockings. What are they called? Fishnet stockings. I've got them on under here today. But you don't mind, do you? We're all friends. You don't mind me sharing those little things with you. Plus, a quarter of a bottle of beautiful scent. Only had it for 4 years. Bra size 40 AF. I think that might be another April Fool's joke. So there's this morning's very, very fascinating and interesting April Fool's jokes. Do you know any others? Well, lines are open now, boys and girls. Our phone lines have just opened. If you have an April Fool joke, or have you been tripped up by an April Fool's joke before? What happened? What was the joke? You can tell me this morning by calling in 020-8144-3477. Oh, incidentally, look carefully at the screens. Now, you know that the United Kingdom talk, the flag there, the Union flag there. When we went from picture to picture, sometimes it moved a little bit left, right, up, down, or bigger or smaller. Sometimes it always moved a little bit, although you may well not have noticed, because I didn't know how to get it in exactly the same place. Well, I've learnt this morning. I can do it now. Watch this. The flag won't move. Watch. See, look at that. Doesn't move anymore. Even when we switch cameras, look, the flag is in exactly the same. Isn't that clever? The flag is in exactly the same place. Oh, hang on, is it on three or not? There it is, look, it's in exactly the same. How clever is that? We are learning slowly how to work this damn equipment. April Fools then, okay? April Fools. April Fools, that's what we want. Have you been tripped up in the past, maybe another year, by an April Fools joke? Tell me about it. 020-8144-3477 is my phone number this morning. If you have Skype, you can Skype in. Skype name is United Kingdom Talk. All one word, United Kingdom Talk. Let's do some more messages. Good morning to the lovely Vera Taylor. We missed you last night, Vera. You weren't at the karaoke last night. No, it was Maureen. No Maureen last night. I missed Maureen last night. Oh, she wasn't there. Apparently, she was at the Daily Mail Ideal Home Exhibition. Do you know, I didn't even know that was on. I thought that was kind of May, June time, but apparently it's happened. The Daily Mail Ideal Home Exhibition. Excellent. Oh, hang on, what's happening there? Just a minute. Let me just move something off there. Good. Good morning to Kevin Webster, who says, I saw you in Boys. Did you? I think it was QX, actually. I think we were in QX. There was a few photos of the karaoke, weren't they, at Central Station. Ray Reynolds says, wasn't that terrible about Russell Brand dying in the night? Ray, that's an April Fool's joke. You will not trip me up, dear. Come on, Ray. I don't laugh at your jokes normally. It's not going to happen again any more easily on an April Fool's Day, is it, dear? Russell Brand didn't die in the night, unfortunately. Only his career. His career died alone. He's a dreadful man, isn't he? I hope I never, ever have to meet Russell Brand. Dreadful man. Good morning to Jake Riley, who says, hope you have a nice day. You too, Jake. Hope the guitar playing's going well for you. Waynie Martin's with us, who says, oh my God, waking up and hearing you singing, I thought it was a nightmare. Waynie, I heard that you forgot one of your leads last night. Is that right? How terribly, terribly unprofessional you are, darling. I mean, for God's sake, man. Sure. Oh, hang on a minute. Can I just get something down from my shelf? Because I want to take something into work tonight. Just up there. Where is that now? That's it. Got it. Okay. It's all right. I'm having a little issue with one of the microphones. And I've got a spare. I've got a new one. It's a radio mic. I've got a brand new radio mic in a box, but I don't like to use the new ones. Honestly, I have. I've got a brand new radio mic in a box, but I've got an old one, and I like to use the old one for as long as possible so that I don't have to use the new one. I'm terrible like that. I buy clothes sometimes. They can sit in the wardrobe until they're out of fashion again because I don't want to wear them out. And the same with trainers. I bought some lovely shoes, Ralph Lauren shoes, at half price around Christmas time, just after Christmas. They're still in the cupboard, waiting for the other ones to be worn out. And when I say worn out, you know, there's got to be holes in things for me before I throw them away. That's true, that is. Anyway, I've got a spare old radio mic. I'm going to try that tonight and see how that one works, because we were getting a lot. I don't know if you noticed it on the Monday, Ray. It was clicking and popping. If you're wondering what I'm talking about, as well as doing this, I do karaoke nights as well, you see. The next one's on Sunday in Sydenham at the Golden Lion at 9 o'clock, which is in London if you want to come there. And the microphone, it was going a little bit like that, popping and clicking, and I can't work out whether it's the receiver or the microphone. So I'll take another microphone tonight, use that with the same receiver and see how that goes, all right? Thank you, Waynie. So, Waynie, do try. I always have spares with me, right, Waynie? Very unprofessional, dear. He left a cable at home last night. You shouldn't take it out of the car. Don't take anything out of the car. Worst thing you can do. I've got spare cables in my car, all sorts of spares I carry around with me everywhere. Good morning to Jason Allen. Morning, Jason. Time to change your calendar. Thank you, Jason. I'm glad that you noticed. That wasn't an April Fool's joke, boys and girls. It is really time to change the Barry Manilow calendar over there to April. So one moment, please. There we are. Ba ba da ba ba. Even now at the Copacabana. There we are. The Barry Manilow April picture is him standing like this. How does he stand like that? Gosh, that must be very uncomfortable. Thank you very much, Jason, for correcting me. Always feel free to come and correct me, yes. Good morning to Michael Doan. Morning, Michael. Michael Dunn. How are you this morning? I hope you're firing on all cylinders, just like me. Ray says, Captain Birdseye wears fishnets under his strides. I think that's another April Fool's joke there. Captain Birdseye does not wear fishnets. I'm sure he doesn't. Maybe tights. You know a lot of builders wear tights. They do, dear. They told me. Builders wear tights because they get cold. That's true. That is absolutely true. Waynie says, I did have a lead, but it wasn't the spare, for the lead went wrong. Well, you should be carrying spares around with you at all times, Waynie. If you need any advice at all in your little disco karaoke business, just come to Uncle Chris. Remember, I've been there first, Waynie, darling. There's lots of... Waynie keeps putting pictures of himself and young people standing next to him, hoping that he's going to make him look better. But I'm afraid it works the other way, lovey. Never stand next to anyone that you think looks better than yourself, because it makes you look 10 times worse. It does. It does. Good morning to Tanya Sheridan, who's just joining us a little bit late this morning. Tanya, good morning, my darling. Hope you're well, lovey. All right, hope you're well. There we are. I think that's all our messages for now. Oh, what's what's this now? Anne is now pretending to send me naked pictures of Barry Manilow. You're not going to trip me up. You will not trip me up. I'm telling you now. All right. 0208 144 3477 is my phone number this morning. Now, let me see. Shall we do a story this morning? Let's start off with a story. One Direction. Now, if you want to make money, you don't want to be working in a bank or anything like that. This is what you want to do. You need to be in a band. Particularly a boy band. In the Daily Mail this morning, just 7 years ago, they were schoolboys revising for their GCSEs and A-levels. Oh, how boring is that, dear? How boring was school? Oh, you get them all going to university. Oh, we've been to university. We're very, very intelligent. Yeah, but you've got no social skills, have you? You just sit there in your little groups in the corner of... But I had a group in last night. Oh, you could spot them a mile off. University students or people that have just come out of university, and they sit on a little table and they're on their phones. They've got glasses on. They're on their phones all night. Chat, chat, chat. And then you say something to them and it goes completely silent and they just look at you because they don't get anything. The snowflake generation, they don't get anything, dear. They don't get anything. You spot them. So boring. University. Oh, God, I'm so glad I didn't go. Today, Harry Styles, Louis Tomlinson. You make, take your pick out of this lot, boys and girls. All right. Today, Harry Styles, Louis Tomlinson, Zanik Malik. Zanik. Zayn Malik. All those tattoos, Zayn, dear. What are you doing to that pretty boy body of yours, lovey? Eh? Yeah, that pretty boy body. I'd just like to lick up and down those little arms where those tattoos are. Zayn Malik, Niall Horan and Liam Payne, collectively known as No Erection, are worth a staggering, how much? Go on. £262 million. Oh, you could build a hospital with that. Oh, they shouldn't have all that money. Oh, you could build a hospital. Now, if they're worth that, how much money do you reckon old fat cow was made out of that? Big boy fat Simon Cow. With the badly... you'd think he'd spend some money on clothes, wouldn't you? Simon Cow, dear. Come on, Simon. Stop wandering. He does make me laugh. He's got... He like wears an expensive jacket, a little bit like myself, but underneath it, he's got some moth-eaten T-shirt on it. God's sake. What you need is some nice clothes, Simon, and a little bit of liposuction, dear. Little bit of liposuction. Suck that fat out. Maybe you can get one of your many girlfriends to do that with a straw. That's actually, I've seen, have you ever seen liposuction being done? Oh, it's gruesome. It's gruesome. They get this metal thing in there. Oh, it's awful. How could anyone let themselves go through that? Although Simon Cow needs to. I wonder how much he makes. So those boys have now got about £50 million each. Wow. This week's records filed at Companies House showed the X Factor graduates have sold 10 shares in their firm One Direction Media, netting them a cool £14 million each, dear. Oh, just think what I could do with a couple of £1 million. We could have a proper studio with glass and people in the office typing just like they do at BBC News 24. Wouldn't it be fabulous? I could have banks of people out there tapping away on a computer, looking important. I would like that. I could have several people next door waiting to answer the ever-ringing phone. Which may be not working this morning. Is it an April Fool's joke where no one's going to ring in? Is that what it is? Is that what it is this morning? I could have that. I could have moving cameras. You know, like they do on the TV shows where the camera... like on a track like that. I wouldn't have to press any of my own buttons. There'd be someone doing that. We could have Adam the plumber could do that. He'd be good at that. I could have him in every week, pushing the buttons in another office, and I'd just sit there in front of my... Oh, £14 million. Oh, dear. Terrifyingly, all these boys are 25 or under, with all five making the Sunday Times under 30 rich list last year. Of course, I was in that years ago, the Sunday Times rich list, dear. Thank you very much. I was at number 3, just beneath the Queen of England. I was lovely. To put this into context, the Beatles had each made only £1.1 million at a similar point. Oh, so you're saying they're better than the Beatles, One Direction? Are they? even taking into account inflation, this works out at a comparatively paltry £16.7 million per Beatle. Unless, of course, you step on one of them. Don't step on Beatles. They're pretty harmless Beatles. They're nice little things. They just want to go along the pavement and go along on their doing their work. I wonder what Beatles do. What do Beatles do, apart from sing? What do the Beatles, the little black ones with the legs running along the ground, what do they actually do? Anyone know that? In the process, the One Direction Quintet. That sounds like a gay word, doesn't it? Quintet, a group of five gays. Don't you think it sounds like that? What do you mean gay? Do you mean LGBT? No, I don't. I'm not LGBT. I'm gay. That's it. Gay. LGBT, WXYZ. What's all that about? Oh, everyone needs to feel involved. Well, I'm not involved. Do I look bisexual? Do I look like a lesbian? No, gay. LGBT rubbish. To the companies through which they funnel their earnings. I wonder what that means, funnel their earnings. One Direction Media, Roll Call, Touring and PPM. The money rolls in from music royalties, merchandising, touring and seven-finger endorsement bills. Perhaps you can get One Direction underpants. I wonder who would have the biggest pair of pants out of that lot. What do you reckon? Perhaps we should run a competition. Harry Styles is the hot one. 23 years old, £56 million he's worth. Once upon a time, he's from Norfolk Farm Labourers. Styles grew up in Worcestershire, Redditch, later moving to Cheshire, where he attended Holmes Chapel Comprehensive, just a few miles from the modest £400,000 three-bed family home. And it goes on and tells you all about them and what they've got and that. But, good luck to them. Does anyone feel... You know, when I see young people like that who've been pop stars, and I see that they've got all that money and what have you, and I'm not in any way at all jealous or upset by that. And yet, if I told you the bloke in charge of Barclays Bank earned £4 million last year, you wouldn't like that, would you? Isn't that funny? Why are we like that? If I told you perhaps that last year I earned £250 million through my vast property empire, you'd probably be okay with that, wouldn't you? But if I told you the boss of Sainsbury's earned £10 million last year, you wouldn't like that. Now, why is that? Do we just take a natural liking to some people and not others? Do you think that's what it is? If you learnt that the little old lady who's 70 years old down the road just won the National Lottery, £13 million, you'd like that, wouldn't you? How about the boss of British Airways earning £15 million last year? Nope, don't like that. Strange, isn't it? How we kind of choose what we like and maybe what we don't like as well. What was that? How strange and mysterious, boys and girls. Strange and mysterious. Now, just a minute. I had another story there. Where's that gone there? Oh, I can't get that up now. Anyway, that's the One Direction, boys. Let's do some of your little messages coming in on today's worldwide phenomenal broadcast show. Vera says, I work for Sainsbury's. No chance. Ah, Vera, you need to work your way up, lovey. Come on, lovey. You've got to work your way up, darling. From the shelves and the checkouts, you need to move up to management positions. That's where the thousands of pounds are, lovey. Me simply by going into my local Sainsbury's supermarket a couple of weeks ago and looking at the miserable staff, and the customers are more miserable than the staff in Sainsbury's. They're awful people. Dreadful. And poor Vera has to look at their sad, miserable faces while she's serving them. Beep, beep. Dreadful, Vera. You need to get into management. You stay there, girl, and work your way up. Work your way up. Anne says, I posted them under your pre-show video. No, you didn't, Anne. Bet you didn't. No, you didn't. Don't believe you. There we are. There's a little story for you this morning. Let's have another one. Where are we now? Thomas Cook. What a fantastic idea this is. Are you ready for this one, boys and girls? Don't forget, you can call in, should you want to, 0208 144 3477, or just keep listening. Just keep listening. So Thomas Cook this morning, we're always looking for new and innovative ways to help keep our customers at the heart of everything we do. Whatever you want from your holiday, we do it for you. So when you told us you don't want to worry about catching too much sun when in hot destinations, we saw this as a great challenge. And I like this. I like it when companies listen to people and do something about it. We'd all rather come back from our holiday looking more sun-kissed than lobster-like. So we've swapped our sun hats for thinking caps and have come up with the perfect solution to keep you safe in the summer. It's called Lotion in Motion. Now, this is fantastic. This is fantastic. With a tan-do attitude. Do you like that? The tan-do attitude. We've worked hard to find a way for holidaymakers to enjoy the sun. We do like a bit of sun, don't we, boys and girls? We like a bit of sun. Lotion in Motion is a highly advanced sun cream delivery drone which keeps you protected on hot. Now, do you know what? There should be a little Union Jack up there. Where's that gone now? Hang on, let me do it for you. I do it, look, it's all very clever. I'll do it live. Let's put that there, which will be too big. And then we do, I think I do that. Can I do this? no, I can't. One moment. Sorry, just talk amongst yourselves a moment. I've got to copy that little one there. How do I do that? One minute. Transform. Copy transformation. And then we put it on there. One minute. Got to make that small now. And I should be able to paste, and that will then. Yes, look at that. Look at how clever is that there. You see? I meant to put that on there. Yeah, so we got one here. Now, see, it doesn't move now. Look, it's in exactly the same place. I'm very proud of that, boys and girls. Oh, very, very proud of that. Very proud of that, of what I've discovered today. Back to the story. Lotion in Motion is a highly advanced sun cream delivery drone which keeps you protected on holiday. Specially designed to carry sun creams, it features flight orientation orbital lasers to detect your tan levels and determine when you need your lotion topping up. Fab, isn't it? If your levels of sun exposure are too high, a process is triggered, boys and girls, releasing sun cream from the drone. Straight onto your back. Yes, this tops up your existing sun protection and covers the most effective areas of your body. What a great idea. So what they've got is a drone. Thomas Cook, this is brand new. Thomas Cook have got a drone which carries suntan lotion. And it detects, I don't know how they do it, it's very, very clever. It detects who needs more suntan lotion. And it flies over you while you're there and then stops on you and puts the suntan lotion on your back. What an excellent idea. You see, if I could only come up with someone that like that, then I could win loads of money and we could do this even better than we're doing it now. Although you'll probably think that's pretty impossible. So that's a nice little story there, isn't it, boys and girls? Let's have a look here. Ah, I know what I meant to ask you. Rather disappointingly, I use... Good morning, Stephen. I use TomTom sat-nav. Now, you've often heard me talk about it on the show. The TomTom sat-nav I've got is an app on my phone. And I've had this for a few years ago, and it's just brilliant. It is absolutely brilliant, the TomTom sat-nav app. But they are retiring it. They are retiring it in December. At least not, they're not turning the app off completely, but there's not going to be any more updates. Now, I've got it here from the website Pocket GPS World. For those of you still using the original TomTom iPhone app, which is me, the company have just released an update with a note forewarning that updates will cease in September and citing changes in TomTom and Apple technologies for the decision. TomTom launched their new smartphone app, the TomTom Go, in 2015, and they offered us all free upgrades to this. But a couple of people I know tried it and just didn't like it. It said it reflected the user interface changes that had been made on its equipment, and unlike its predecessor, the new app was free and came bundled with a limited number of navigation miles. To unlock unlimited navigation, you have to buy 1 or 3 years access. Unfortunately, the app met with decidedly lukewarm reviews. The interface was dumbed down and, despite some updates, lacks core functionality that was available in the original app. Now, how do you improve something and make it worse? Now, we've seen this with a lot of stuff over the years. Coca-Cola. Do you remember that? Do you remember when they reinvented Coca-Cola and people didn't like it? Why, oh why, do people try and fix things that are not broken? I do not understand it. Maybe you know some examples on that, of other things that haven't been broken and yet someone's tried to fix and make them worse. Now, I remember the Coca-Cola. There was something else as well, I think. Was it Cadbury's chocolate? I don't know. But anyway, Coca-Cola had to bring back out Coca-Cola Classic because people didn't like the new version. I mean, how stupid can you be? You've got a very successful product making millions of pounds and some completely retarded person decides that they can make it better. And it don't work. Stupid. Well, this has happened to the TomTom app. Which is, I'm just so disappointed about this. The story goes on. Many of us have clung on to the original app because when they offered you the new app free, which I think I can still do that, I can still get the new app free, it doesn't delete the old one. So it's like buying a completely new app. It's not like an upgrade to your one. So that one still works. And a lot of people took the free one. Perhaps I should try it. I don't know. A lot of people took the free app, okay, tried it, and then went back to the old one. I haven't actually downloaded the new one. It says, so many of us have clung on to the original TomTom app despite being offered a free upgrade for those who had bought the older version. But without map updates, it seems we have little option but to move to TomTom Go or another navigation app after September. And it's is it September? I thought it said December somewhere. I'm sure it's December. I might be wrong with that. I don't know. But it's a great shame. Of course, when they say they're not going to update it anymore. Now, I don't know if it's just the map. So once you've got your last set of maps, then that's it. Because that's constantly updated. Every few months, you get an update. You touch a couple of things and it updates it. And it works fantastically. I can't understand why they want to turn it off and move us across to something else that, according to some of the reviews here, no one seems to like it. The question is, it integrates traffic as well and speed cameras. Now, will the traffic and speed camera thing still work after September? That'd be the interesting thing, because I know my way to work. I can take you 10 different ways to work, but I don't know where the traffic is. And of course, you might be saying to yourself, why don't you just look at the traffic reports before you leave home? It doesn't quite work out like that, does it? Because I'm travelling for a minimum of an hour and 15 minutes. Now, I can set up from my house, check the fact, oh, no traffic that route and leave. and then 5 minutes after setting out, there might be an accident on my route. I won't know that. That the TomTom that there is at the moment does know that. Somehow that works. I don't know. Maybe the police, the excellent police force in this country, maybe they see the accident and then they tell someone and then they tell the traffic people. I don't know how that works. It's all very clever. But will that still work after September? Is it just the maps that aren't being updated? In which case, I'll probably be okay, you know, for another couple of years with that same app, after which I very much doubt I'll be driving to London after a couple of years. I can't see that happening, really. The traffic will have done my head in by then. Either that or I'd love to get a driver, something like that. Would you like to be my driver? Have you got a nice car? I'm not going in a Skoda, dear. We're not going in a Ford. We're not going to work in a Ford, dear. Please. God's sake. So my question to you is, do you use a sat-nav, a sat-nav app on your phone? If so, what's it like? Now, here's what I need. I need the map so I know where I'm going to. I need to be able to type in the address and it'll tell me where to go. I want it to reroute me automatically if it sees traffic ahead while I'm driving along. And I want it to tell me where the speed cameras are. Not that that matters, to be honest, because I honestly, I'm no word of a lie, I don't speed. I don't speed anymore. Since I've got this bigger car, it's lovely. It's so relaxing to sit there like above the cars and just take it easy. I don't speed anymore. So I don't really need the speed cameras. Although saying that, it's nice. It's nice to have a beep, beep every time you're coming up to one. I had Google Maps on last night on the way home. I downloaded Google Maps because one of the young boys at work, Alex is his name, he said Google Maps is a good one. And I said, does that do traffic reroutes? He said, yeah. So the trouble is I don't want to put it on and then not know how it's working. I need to have a good look at that. I'll probably do that when I finish the show today. Have a look at it and see exactly how it works. Because you don't want to be fiddling around and have to pull over and start fiddling around with it because you know what you're doing. So Google Maps is a possibility. Do you have one that you could recommend? If so, if you could put a little message or maybe send an email or even call in. I don't mind. Whatever you want to do. Then I would be interested to know what one you've got. 020-8144-3477. 020-8144-3477. Okay. Vera says, my tan level. Vera, your tan level is lovely, darling. I love the darker skin. You know that, my love. Have you not noticed how I am a little bit tanned? Eh? Have you not noticed that today? I'm a little bit tanned? Eh? Eh? That's what we need. Tanned boyfriend. If you could find someone for me, Vera, of similar tanning qualities to yourself, then I'd be very happy. I'd be very, very happy. Wouldn't that be nice? Thank you very much, Vera. There might be someone you know who could be interested in me and my sad, lonely, pathetic life. Thank you. Vectis says, the big flag was better covering your face. How rude you are. The big flag may cover my face, my love, but if you was in this studio, Vectis, don't think it would cover yours, would it, lovey? Eh? I don't think that big old flag would cover your little chubby cheeks. They wouldn't. Those chubby cheeks would be, there'd be a flag like that, and then the cheeks would be sticking out either side of it, wouldn't they? Thank you, Vera. Thank you, Vera. Remember, same sort of skin colour as yours, my darling. That would be perfect for me. Thank you very much. Vera says, the customers make us miserable. Stop complaining. Don't they moan? Oh, God. I mean, you get them all in supermarkets, dear. I was in Waitrose once a couple of years ago, and there was a woman complaining at the desk that she'd bought a bag of oranges and one of them was slightly green and not orange. Could she have a refund? Don't they moan and they moan and they moan. Ray Reynolds says, get a driver, Parker. Yeah, I might do that. yes, m'lady, take off my bra. Yes, m'lady, Parker. Yes, m'lady, take off my panties. Yes, m'lady, Parker. Yes, m'lady, don't let me ever catch you wearing them again. Rachel doesn't like moaning either, do you, Rachel? No, we don't like people that moan all the time. We really don't. 0208 144 3477 is my phone number this morning. Now, Eurovision fans, I already bought you a piece of fake news last week about the Eurovision coming out with Brexit. Well, I thought it was fake news. Here's an article this morning in today's pink paper. The BBC. Good morning from BBC One. Colour. The BBC is set plans to announce... The BBC... I'll start that again for you. The BBC is set to announce plans to withdraw the UK from the Eurovision Song Contest. Ba, 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 ba. In a move which will anger and dismay nearly... Dismay nearly half of all Brits. Plans are afoot for Scotland to compete by itself. This is in this morning's pink paper. We understand that the withdrawal will come into effect in the first few months of 2019, meaning the UK will just have two more goes at winning the Eurovision Song Contest. Ba, 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 ba. Eurovision will also not be shown on the BBC past next year after months of tempestuous negotiations broke down last night. A source close to BBC Director General Tony Hall, it's so, so important, aren't you, Tony? Oh, you're a very, very important person, aren't you, lovey? Said the Prime Minister had forced his hand by instructing the corporation this week to make at least £350,000 in annual cuts. He had felt no choice but to drastically reduce the BBC's payments into the European Broadcasting Union, which, as the same source said, stands at close to £350,000 this year, up from £310,000 in 2010. However, the European Broadcasting Union insisted that if the UK cut its contribution by more than half, it would no longer gain automatic entry into the contest. They would have to compete in the Eurovision semi-final. Oh dear. However, the EBU, through fraught discussions, which has emerged, first began in June last year. This was one demand the BBC consistently refused to agree with. Professor Kivinti Duriti, a Ukrainian Eurovision expert, has written 50 articles on the subject and teaches courses on the Eurovision at Kiev University. She said she wasn't surprised by the news. The UK has become more and more resentful of taking part in the European endeavour. It has become a joke to many people and everyone else is indifferent. Perhaps now this money can be spent on other things, like the health industry. Graham Norton, you know, the mythic the little Irishman. The leprechaun, Graham Norton, who hosts the UK's coverage of the event, said he was distraught and angered by the news, boys and girls. Distraught and angered. Eurovision will continue to exist, but we won't be in it. It's devastating, he said. The contest is completely ridiculous, but I've loved making fun of it over the last few years and I'll miss it. However, he agreed with the BBC that the UK competing in a semi-final would like backfire. We'd probably lose to Germany on penalties anyway, Norton quipped. The Union flag has zoomed down from 24th to both in the last 2 years out of 26th and 27th countries and has come bottom three times this millennium. Three times, lovies. The country's last win came in 1997 with Katrina and the Waves. Love, shine a light. But Scott Mills, who commentated on the Eurovision semi-finals from BBC Three, Colour, said this alone was no reason to withdraw and the UK should have agreed to the European Broadcasting Union's rules. If we sulked and left every competition we don't win for a while, we'd never play the World Cup, he said. He thought it was a tragedy. Tragedy. It's a tragedy. The UK had pulled out and vowed to start my own song contest, even if I have to do it at my own local pub. How about that? That could be a good... Do you know there's not a singing competition in any of the pubs, is there, at the moment? Singing competition. An aide to Nicola Sturgeon said that the SNP had been in secret talks with Scottish Television, which is also a member of the European Broadcasting Union. Okay, Minow. To ensure that Scotland at least keeps broadcasting the event and for Scotland to have its own entry. Yeah! Oh, Nicola Lovey, maybe you could sing it as well, dear. Nicola Sturgeon representing Scotland at the Eurovision Song Contest. Now there's a thing. But would she still be wearing that same little old red outfit that she keeps coming out with time and time again? God, that thing must be filthy now. I bet she reeks in that. Give it a wash, lovey, for Christ's sake. It is understood that in a rare sign of cross-party unity, Scottish Conservative leader Ruth Davidson and Scottish leader Labour leader Kelsa Dugdale are supportive of Nicola Sturgeon's idea of Scotland having their own entry. A source close to Ruth Davidson said that there's even talk about a referendum on whether Scotland should rejoin the Eurovision. They love little referendums up there, don't they? Oh, it's a I think possibly that is the most exciting thing that Scots do, have referendums. That there isn't anything else to do there, is there? They just have referendums. Is that what it is? They want one a year. Bit like a game show, really, isn't it? They could all sit there every night. And now on BBC One, Scotland, it's time for tonight's referendum. Ba 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 ba. And here's your host, Mr. Dow Winton. Oh, hello. I'm Dow Winton and welcome to today's referendum. All orange. Do you think Donald Trump has got his sort of looks, the way he wants to look, has been watching Dow Winton and that's what he wants to look like with that orange face? Is that what it is, lovey? 62% of BBC One viewers in BBC One Scotland colour watched Eurovision last year compared to only 48% across the whole of the United Kingdom. Terrible. Terrible. And that's the story there. So Eurovision, it could all be over, boys and girls. I think it could all be over very, very soon. Oh, dear, dear me. Let's go back to some of your more of your things. Anne Taplin says, will Scotland pay a quarter of the national debt if they vote to leave? What, the Eurovision Song Contest? Possibly. Is it possible? Is it possible? Kevin Webster says, ABBA was the best. Kevin, I was watching them live win the Eurovision Song Contest. That's how old I am. I saw it happen. ABBA, Waterloo. There's no sound like ABBA, is there? Next week, here in the studio, I'm hoping to have ABBA here for a little bit of a chat. I'm trying to get hold of them now, boys and girls. Don't know whether they can make it. They're very, very busy doing their own little things, aren't they now? Ray Reynolds says, Quest TV say they will transmit the Eurovision Song Contest live from the empty shell that was once Molly Moggs. What a good idea. What a good idea. Rachel Davis says, unlike the miserable buggers in Sainsbury's queue in that shop, queue in that shop near the O2. Ah, now that's a Tesco's, isn't it, Rachel? Because we've been in there buying sweeties. Buying sweeties before the Barry Manilow concert. Anne Taplin's got naked pictures of Barry Manilow, apparently. Don't know if he has or not. Not sure if he has naked pictures, really. All right. OK, we're going to wrap up very shortly, boys and girls. Let me just see anything else that we've got to do today. Yes, birthdays. Oh, you want to know what today's item of fake news is, don't you?
We are fighting the fake news.
Fake news.
It's fake. Phony. Fake. A few days ago, I called the fake news the enemy of the people.
Enemy of the people.
And they are. They are the enemy,
of the people. Fake
They're
news.
They're very dishonest people that I called the fake news the enemy of the people. The fake news. And now I'm saying, oh, no, this is no good. But you are fake news. But I am.
You are fake news.
Only against the fake news media or press. Fake.
Go Donald. It's all fake news, boys and girls. Fake news. So this morning's fake news is, there's been a few this morning. The Eurovision Song Contest, I noticed. The date at the top of the paper was the 1st of April. I'm really, really sorry to the very millions and millions. I don't think they've got millions of people in Scotland, have they? Is it just a couple of hundred? How many people live in Scotland? Anyone know, lovey? I'd live in Scotland. What a beautiful country that is. Oh, the Highlands. Oh, you can go for miles and miles and not see anyone. In particular, the miserable customers from Sainsbury's. They don't live in Scotland. Oh, they're so miserable in there. Please, look, do yourself a favour. If you want a little outing, do you want something to do, OK? And you don't usually go in one. I want you to go into Sainsbury's either today or even better tomorrow. Oh, it's like a war zone in there tomorrow. Here they come, the mothers with 10 pushchairs all next to each other. I've got a buggy. Get out of my way. I got a buggy. I wish they had tyres that they pumped up because I would put glass underneath those tyres, being very careful, of course, not to damage the child in the pram, just the tyre. I got a back. Psst. Oh no. No Sainsbury's customers in the Highlands of Scotland. Let's all move there. Go tomorrow or today to a Sainsbury's and walk round and you tell me that I'm lying. Because you won't be able to. The Eurovision story was fake, boys and girls. It's fake news. Fake news. Fake news. The Thomas Cook drone sun lotion was a fake story this morning. It's fake news. Two fake news stories for this morning. It just gets better and better, doesn't it? Was there another one? Can't remember now. It's so long ago. Two items of fake news for you this morning, okay? The Tom Tom story, true. Tom Tom is true. All right? Now let's do today's birthday boys and girls. Any more messages? Nice and quickly, I'll read them out for you before we go. This morning, it is my nephew, Jimmy Butler's birthday, who is 20 years old today. Happy birthday. Oh, we'll have the orchestra out for you, Jimmy. Just a moment. I'll do your one separately, being as you are a close family member. Jimmy, at the moment, his girlfriend... Hang on a minute. Where are we now? Where is it now? Here he comes. Here he comes, Jim. Here we go. This is for my nephew, Jimmy. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to you. Shut up! Shut up! Blimey, what an ending that was. Didn't it go on and on? Happy birthday to my nephew, Jimmy Butler, who is, for his birthday, his girlfriend, a very, very beautiful and slim. My God, she's as skinny as a rat. Vegan, you see. She's vegan. Or is she vegetarian? Not sure. She might be vegetarian, same as me. She's vegetarian, so therefore, Chris Ridden likes you very much. Yes, Charlotte, happy birthday. And at the moment, Jimmy Butler is in a hotel in Lincoln. Charlotte booked him into a hotel for his birthday night celebrations. God knows what happened there. Oh, my God, my poor young nephew. What have you been doing in that hotel? Oh, anyway, that's what they did. That's right. She took him to her hotel for his birthday. So happy birthday to Jimmy Butler, 20 today. Other birthdays today, Ashley Royce. Good morning, Ashley. It's his birthday today. Ashley's a top man. He used to come to Belushi's in Hammersmith. You heard some of his Facebook updates as well on the show last week. He does some really good Facebook updates. So happy birthday to you, Ashley. Happy birthday to you, Tom Anthony. God's years since I saw you. Happy birthday, Tom. To Georgex Smiths. Georgex Smith, 40 years old today. Chantell Bushes, 66 today. Sam Adam, a very young 28 today. AJ Willard Rao, happy birthday to you. Felicity White. Clive Andrews is 50. My God, Clive. 50 years old today. Where did that go? Happy birthday, Clive. Fabio White, it's his birthday today. Lily Shambles. Oh, Fag Ashlil. Fag Ashlil, where are you, darling? Happy birthday to you, my love. All right. And Debbie Hegarty is 48 years old today. So happy birthday to you all.
We are fighting the fake news.
Oh, shut up. Wrong one. There we go. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to you. All right. Enjoy your birthdays, boys and girls. Just a couple more messages before we disappear today. Anne Taplet. Vera says scooters. What about scooters? Scooters. What about I'm not with you, Vera. You'll have to be very, very quick on that typing to answer that, because I don't know what you mean. Scooter. There's just a word there. She's written scooters. I bet you can't type that by the time I say goodbye. Otherwise, we won't know what you're talking about. Scooters? What's she going on about scooters? Time to disappear this evening, boys. This morning, boys and girls. Enjoy your Saturday. Tonight, I'll be doing some DJing tonight and hosting cabaret at Central Station Bar in Wharfdale Road, King Cross. We've got excellent cabaret tonight. We've got Lizzie Drip, who's really very good. All right, Lizzie Drip is your cabaret tonight at Central Station in Wharf. Oh, hang on, what am I doing there? In Wharfdale Road, King's Cross. That's at 10:30 showtime. And I'm doing some DJing 9:30 until midnight on the Saturday. It looks like a nice day out there. I'll probably walk up to the swimming pool now and have a little bit of a swim. Tidy up the house a bit. I must do something in the kitchen. I've kind of given the kitchen completely over to my cat. And it's starting to look rather messy there, unfortunately. So I must clean that up. Vera, did you answer? No. Going to have to go. Enjoy your Saturday, OK? Any more April Fool's jokes? Play them on people before 12 o'clock. You've got to get them done. See you very soon, all right? Bye-bye now.